New Jersey 101.5. Our own radio station. Not New York. Not Philadelphia. Proud to be New Jersey.
New Jersey 101.5.
And New Jersey chime time is 9:09. John Stewart may be leaving, but Vic is sticking around.
From the man who brought you the viral video Bread and Milk, Vic Dibitetto, and from the man who brought you a virus last week, Steve TRevelise.
There he is, the man with the very, very funny Beatles video, the man who's spouting about Kanye West, Vic Dibitetto. How you doing, pal?
Good evening, Mr. TRevelise, and how are you?
I am good. I love the Beatle video. That was great. That was absolutely great, commemorating 51 years.
That was one of the hardest vignettes to set up. I had to do the dolls set up. I had to put a camera on a tripod. Then I had to go in the back and position myself. But it was worth it. It was fun, right?
Oh, it's great. It's on NJ1015.com.
Nice, because 1964, February 9th, which is my birthday, I was 3 years old.
Uh-huh.
And I remember it well. I was 3 years old, and I lived in Brooklyn. I was next to the TV. I had a Beatle wig. I was imitating myself. And I thought my family was watching me, but they were watching the Beatles.
See that?
And from that day in, the needle was hooked. That's why I love the Beatles, man. They're just the greatest harmonies, and no two songs are the same. And they went from Love Me Do to Helter Skelter in a few years. Just unbelievable. I love them.
And how do you feel like 51 years later, Paul goes from fronting the Beatles to backing Kanye West?
I never miss John Lennon and George Harrison more than watching that debacle, that train wreck. What the hell? First of all, you couldn't hear him. Did they need him? Did they? Just, I don't know. It just him. I mean, Nirvana, okay. David Grohl, okay. But Kanye, what? Conway, no talent. What? Look, I don't want to. This isn't a race issue. I mean,
no.
You give me Barry White, you give me Marvin Gaye and Motown. That's music. I have no idea what this crap that this guy's putting out. Not only that, he's got an attitude. This guy has the world by the balls, and he's got that smug pussy. You just want to slap him in the face with that pussy he's got. What is his problem? Can't you smile? And who the hell are you? Who gives you the balls to go up on stage and interrupt somebody's dream? Not once, but the second time. Does anybody? I swear to God, I hope one day AC/DC wins an award and he comes up and they clock him in that skull with the mic stand.
You know what? It's year after year, and he's. I think Paul gives him credibility. And that's why Paul was there. I don't know what the hell Paul was doing there to begin with.
First of all, he's starting to look more and more like Bruce Jenner. Just let his hair, pull the hair out. Stop dying the hair. Let Zeppelin and the Bee Gees, how nice they look. Paul, come on, man. You're not the cute guy on Ed Sullivan anymore. Just stop. Stop.
Nah, you're right. You're right. He's got the young wife. I mean, he did carry it off though, because when he was on stage, he had the personality. You know what I mean? He was Paul.
The mic was off. You couldn't hear him.
That I couldn't understand. You couldn't. You know, he writes part of the song. He gives them credibility. They couldn't give him like one verse to sing.
Exactly. He was like just a backup guy. It was. I don't know. Hey, look. You know, I don't. I didn't. I don't. I'm not a big Lady Gaga fan, but I tell you that was a nice. I like that, her and Tony Bennett. That was nice.
They were great together. They were great. And Jeff Lynne working with Ed Sheeran, that was great too. A lot of duets last night. I mean, Sunday night.
Yeah, but that one with him and Con, I don't know. I don't get it. Then again, who the hell am I? I don't know.
It's all an act, and you know, I don't believe that the Grammys let it happen, but then they only let it happen so people will talk about it the next day. We allow this guy to make an ass of himself so the people will talk about it the next day.
Yeah, and now I heard Beck's album, the record sales are going through the roof because of that.
Yeah, he plays 14 instruments, and he doesn't respect the music.
Yeah. It's not about the artistry. Please just stop.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just so tired of these idiots, man. Idiots with money. Morons with money. That's all it is.
It would be a new sitcom, Morons with Money,
yeah.
Starring Kanye West.
Hey, right after Mike and Molly, morons with morons.
Hey, man, where are you going to be?
Oh, with you.
Absolutely.
February 20th, Sarcasm in the Crown Point Hotel in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. And to all my Philly fans, I'm telling you now, you're busting my balls on Facebook. When are you going to come to Philly? It's right over to the Palmyra, the Palmolive Bridge, whatever.
Ben Franklin Bridge, the Palmolive Bridge.
Stop your whining, because I'm not going to be back in the Philly area for a long time. So it's going to be a great show. It's a great venue, plenty of parking, nice hotel, and you're going to love it.
Dude, they love you down there. The manager is a big Vic Dibitetto fan. I mean, you put it on a Facebook page, I immediately got calls. I mean, you got Woodbury. I mean, you got a solid following down there. Cherry Hill Crown Plaza, sarcasmcomedy.com. Hey, while we're talking about duets, I'm going to do duets this hour because there were so many at the Grammys. What's your favorite duet?
This is really going off on a limb here. Remember the Christmas song by David Bowie and Bing Crosby?
Oh, yeah.
I loved that. That was a great combination.
Yeah.
They made one song, Peace on Earth, rum-pum-pum-pum. That was a great combination.
You know, public television is running a Bing Crosby like bio, and they talk about that song. And David Bowie didn't want to sing Drummer Boy. And the only reason, in fact, he didn't want to sing Drummer Boy. So in order to appease David Bowie, they wrote those lyrics for him, the Peace on Earth. They wrote that like that day. And the only reason that David Bowie did the song in the first place was because he said his mother loved Bing Crosby.
See what I mean about you, Steve? You're like, I never knew this. You're like the source of them. How did you? I never knew that. That is great.
And Crosby dies. That's like the last song Crosby sang, I think. And he dies like shortly after.
Wow. I never knew that.
1977.
Wow. Man. Wow.
I like that. Bing Crosby, David Bowie. And look at that. Two icons from two completely different worlds.
How about this one? Remember the Elvis Presley and Frank Sinatra one on Ed Sullivan? Witchcraft?
Oh, yeah. When they sang it like each other.
Yeah, and right. He's imitating Elvis, and Elvis is imitating Frank. That was great. Not Paul McCartney and Kanye West. Come on. Dr. Phil says, what were you thinking?
All right, Vic, man, we're going to talk later. Thanks again.
Always a pleasure, Steve. February 20th, folks. Get your asses out there. Take it easy, Steve. Have a great night. Other than that, I can't complain.
You got it, Vic. Love you. 1-800-283-101.5.